Today is the day. What day, Alex? What day do you mean? The day I finished this book, Artificial Intelligence and Deep Learning in Pathology. I got this book, I think, right after it was published in 2020. And now we're in 2023. I managed to finish it. Congratulations to me. Welcome, my digital pathology trailblazers. No, it's not the book that's that difficult. It's me. Why did it take me so long? Well, life comes in between everything nowadays, but that's an excuse. The thing is that when I read text, I fall asleep. So first I got the PDF of this book when it just came out. I reached out to Elsevier and they provided me with a PDF of this book. So big shout out to them. Thank you so much. And I was supposed to read it fast and review it. Didn't happen. Then I tried different strategies on stories on social media to keep me accountable. Didn't happen. It only happened when I started using this application that actually reads text to you. And then I applied this to different publications and everything that I need to read that's nonfiction. So natural reader speech to text, there is going to be another video about that linked in the cards. So I had this app read the book to me. I looked at all the images and diagrams, and now I'm ready to tell you about it. So this book has 270 pages. It's edited by Dr. Stanley Cohen, and different chapters are co-authored by different people specializing in different areas of digital and computational pathology. So let's just quickly go through the content so that you know what's inside, and then I'm gonna tell you why I like it, because I like it a lot and I very much recommend it. So we have 11 chapters in total. The first chapter, The Evolution of Machine Learning, Past, Present, and Future, is written by Dr. Cohen. Then we have The Basics of Machine Learning Strategies and Techniques, also by Dr. Cohen. In chapter 3, we're going to find the overview of advanced neural network architectures. So here we're going a little bit deeper. This one is written by Benjamin Mitchell. Then in chapter 4, you're going to learn about the complexity and the use of artificial intelligence in anatomic pathology. In chapter 5, you're going to learn about dealing with data, strategies of pre-processing data. Both of those chapters were written by Dr. Cohen. Then chapter 6 by Dr. Parwani, Digital Pathology as a Platform for Primary Diagnosis and Augmentation via Deep Learning. So that's chapter 6. Chapter 7, Applications of Artificial Intelligence for Image Enhancement in Pathology. This is a hot topic because different images from different scanners from different labs look differently. This is a chapter about using AI to make generalizable models on all of those images. Chapter 8 is about precision medicine in digital pathology via image analysis and machine learning. Chapter 9 is AI methods for predictive image-based grading in human cancers. And chapter 10 is AI and the interplay between tumor and immunity. So using image analysis for immuno-oncology, this is a big deal. This is something I started doing straight out of residency, and now we have a more powerful methods. And there is a full chapter on that. And chapter 11 is the overview of the role of AI in pathology, the computer as pathology digital assistant. So this one is written by Dr. Tomaszewski and has plenty of applications. So as you see by the content table, a lot is covered, different aspects of AI in pathology. This book is written by a doctor, not by a computer scientist, and it is intended for non-computer scientists. It explains concept in computer vision, in computer science, in computational pathology, without going into details, into the equations, and into the math behind it. So in my opinion, this is a fantastic resource to bridge the gap between pathologists and computer scientists. And I'm a pathologist, so obviously I was perceiving it from my perspective. Definitely something that gives me the necessary concepts, necessary vocabulary, necessary explanation to communicate well with computer scientists that are then working with me on different computational pathology projects. So after seeing the table of contents, if you have recognized some area that you're working in, this is definitely a lecture for you, at least of that chapter. I would just read the entire book. So I was going into the lecture of this book as already somebody with digital pathology knowledge, with digital pathology background. And when I go into resources about topics that I know something about, I always have this fear, oh, is this going to be a waste of my time? Maybe I already know all that. That was not the case here. And often it's not the case. I don't know why I even think so. But there was enough for me to fill in the blanks. works to connect different dots, different concepts that I already heard about, knew about, but there was no bridge for me yet. So definitely, even if you're advanced in digital pathology, computational pathology is a non-computer scientist, I recommend the book. Is it the best resource for absolute beginner? I'm not sure. I would say if you're comfortable with reading scientific literature and in general professional literature in the medical space, yes, you can totally go read it from A to Z and you're gonna gain tremendous insights. However, if you already have some basic knowledge on artificial intelligence and pathology, this is a fantastic gap filler, fantastic resource to structure your knowledge, to be more confident and to bridge your own gaps. What I loved about it, that it is written in a very clear language. So it is professional medical language. There is no dumbing down of anything, but at the same time, it's so clear compared to scientific papers. This is a lot clearer. There is no deciphering. You just read it and you understand. You do have to analyze the images to understand some concepts, but the language of the book is just clear, straight to the point. Computer vision and computer science terms are explained in normal language. There are no references to coding. There is no need to code or have any computer science skills to benefit from this book. All the concepts that need to be supported by images are supported by images. Often the images come from public domain. So it's also a very nice summary of resources coming from different places, put in the right context for pathology. Just to be clear, as the title says, artificial intelligence and deep learning in pathology, it is about AI and deep learning. It is not the principles of digital pathology, not how scanners work, not about digital pathology workflow. It is about AI and deep learning. But AI and deep learning are now integral parts of digital pathology, so definitely a must read. So you can get this book on Amazon. It even tells you when I purchased it. So like 2 years ago, over 2 years ago, but I read it and I highly recommend it. You can get a paper version and a Kindle version. So I have both and I also listen to it with my app. So if you're serious about understanding AI and pathology, learning about how it works, how it can be explained to humans, what are the ethical considerations? And if you want to be a confident partner in the computational pathology discussion, take part in projects, know what's going on, I highly recommend to read this book. So, and there's going to be a link to Amazon in the description below. So do not wait, get the book, and let's keep bridging the gap between pathology and computer science. And I talk to you in the next episode.